the executive if the executive exceeds limits, or if the executive overlap the legislative powers, if the executive overlap the judiciary powers, ultimately the sufferers are the administrators, especially the nation, particularly the legislative, executive and judiciary bodies, which are very important organs for the administration of justice. Friends, if you see administration of, what is administration of justice? Administration of justice is the justice which is a need of the hour for administration of all the functions properly. Because if a citizen go to the court of law, if there is no proper administration in judiciary, how a citizen's rights can be protected? If a citizen's rights are protected, infringed by the executive, ultimately the citizen will go to the judiciary. If there is no remedy from the judiciary, where the citizen will go? So if the law is made by the legislative body which can infringe the rights of the citizens, if there is no proper mechanism of the judiciary to suggest the rights of the citizens, where they will go and get the remedy? If the judiciary is not properly working, for example, I will tell you, the Supreme Court of India recently not accepting the petitions regarding the NRC and also CAA, even it is not allowed. Ayodhya issue, it is also not allowed. Various issues which are conflict since long back till the date. Why? You have to think about the deprived communities from India, the deprived society from India. If judiciary is failed, ultimately the people are believing that judiciary is the holiest institution which can protect the interest of the nation or the citizens of the country. If the judiciary fails to protect the rights of the citizens, ultimately where is the solution for them? Whether they go to the International Court of Justice? Is it possible a common man to go to the International Court of Justice to get, you know, remedy? Even they are unable to go to the higher judiciary, the common man is not unable to at least to go to the high courts. Can they go to the Supreme Court? If the Supreme Court can do like this, if the high courts can do like this, if the lower courts to do like this, what is the remedy for a deprived persons or deprived communities, deprived societies? If there is no administration of justice in judiciary, if there is no administration of justice in executive, if there is no administration of justice in the legislative bodies, ultimately the sufferers of the society or the victims of the society, the deprived communities, the deprived sections. For example, I will tell you the friends, in higher judiciary there is no reservations. So only some section of the society entering in that higher judiciary. But the progressive judgments are not coming from the deprived sections, because there is no deprived representative is there in judiciary. Not only in judiciary, even if executive, fortunately in the executive there is a reservations are there in even IAS. The all communities, IAS are entering, IPS are entering, or various Indian administrative services are entering. And they are resolving the issues of these communities. But there is no entry in higher judiciary. But only some sections of the society are occupying the important chairs of the higher judiciary. They are denying the deprived communities of rights. For example, if you see the SCST Atrocity Act, recently what happened about the Atrocity Act? If you see the promotions for reservations for SCSTs, what happened? If you see the backward caste, you know, their reservation issue, what happened? Not only reservation issues, most of the deprived community section issues, including women issue, also pending in the Supreme Court, various issues of the Whereas it's also pending in the Supreme Court because of there is no proper representative democratic approach, dynamism in Supreme Court itself. So if the Supreme Court is like that, so where the people will get the remedy for depriving of their rights, constitutional rights? So right to education, right to health, right to proper employment, right to whatever the rights are guaranteed by the Indian, in the Constitution of India, which infringed by the executive body, which are infringed by these, you know, civil society or legislative bodies, if the judiciary also failed to protect the rights of the citizens, so what is the ultimate solutions for them? So that is the reason people are not getting justice. That is the reason they are becoming Naxalites, they are becoming factionists, they are becoming anti-social elements, terrorists. So this is the one of the root cause failures of the administration of justice. So administration of justice failed because of various reasons, but include one of the reason is that the theory of the separation of the functions or the theory of the separation of the, you know, powers, which are not clearly demarcated, defined in particular country's constitution. But fortunately in India, we have clear demarcation of the powers and functions of the legislative, the executive and the judiciary, which are more important organs, very important organs for institutional dynamism in India to progress the India into a better society, egalitarian society, and also a modern India which can protect the all the citizens' rights beyond their caste, beyond their creed, beyond their region, religion, gender, ethnicity, etc., etc., which are there. So that is the reason there is a need of the hour to discuss and debate the issue of the theory of the separation of the power for institutional dynamism, which is also one of the very important constitutional challenge in India, not only India, elsewhere in the world. So it is one of the constitutional challenge to discuss and debate in the present society. So thank you very much for all the, you know, students who are listening properly.